Welcome to PowerPoint Practice 2. To begin, start PowerPoint. Notice how it opens in Backstage View. Under Open, browse to locate your PowerPoint Practice 1 file and select Open. Select File, Save As, Browse, and then navigate to your PowerPoint folder on your flash drive or other location where you save your files. Name the presentation as your last name, underscore your first name, underscore PowerPoint, underscore Practice, underscore 2. There should be 5 slides in your slide deck. Ensure your presentation is in normal view. Compare your screen to the example. With slide 3 selected, on the Home tab in the Slides group, select New Slide and then Reuse Slides. In the Reuse Slides pane, which displays to the right, browse File and navigate to your data files to locate the file PowerPoint Practice 2 and select Open. In the Reuse Slides pane, double-click the first, Fields of Interest, and second, Peer Leaders, slide only to add to your presentation. Do not add the third Peer Leaders slide and do not check the box to keep source formatting. Close the Reuse Slides pane. You should now have 7 slides in your slide deck. On the View tab, in the Presentation View group, change the view from Normal to Slide Sorter. Change the zoom so that all slides are shown on one page. Compare your screen to the example. Select Slide 5, Peer Leaders, and move it to the Slide 3 spot by clicking and holding down and dragging it to the Slide 3 spot. Peer Leaders should be the new Slide 3. Select Slide 7, Any Questions, right-click on the slide, and select Delete Slide. This will remove the slide from the slide deck. Select the non-contiguous slides 1 and 6. To select 2 slides that are not next to each other, select the first slide and ensure it is outlined in red to indicate it is selected. Then, hold down the Control key and select Slide 6. Then, let go of the Control key. Both Slide 1 and 6 should be outlined in red. With Slide 1 and 6 selected, on the Transitions tab, in the Transitions to this slide group, select Fade under Subtle. Notice how Slide 1 and 6 have a star next to them to indicate a transition has been applied. Compare your screen to the example. Select Slide 4. This will deselect the 2 previously selected slides. With Slide 4 active, in the lower right-hand corner, select Slide Show View. In Slideshow or Presentation View, use the arrow on your keyboard or mouse clicks to transition from slide to slide. Notice how the slides with the star or transition fade since a transition was applied. Press Escape on your keyboard to exit out of Slideshow View. On the View tab, in the Presentation Views group, select Normal. On the Thumbnail pane, select Slide 2. It should be outlined in red when selected. Hold the Shift key on your keyboard and select Slide 5. Let go of the Shift key and notice that Slides 2, 3, 4, and 5 are all selected and outlined in red. Since these slides are continuous, use the Shift key to select them. With Slide 2, 3, 4, and 5 selected, on the Transitions tab, select Reveal Transition under Subtle. Notice how all slides in the thumbnail pane have a star next to them since they all have a transition applied. Select Slide 1 so that it is the only active slide and launch the slideshow. Use the arrows on your keyboard to scroll through each slide in the slide deck, paying close attention to the transitions you just applied. Select Slide 3, Peer Leaders. Select the text box with the bulleted list and ensure all of the text inside is selected. On the Home tab, in the Font group, use the Increase Font Size button to increase the size of the font to 28. If necessary, unbold the text. With Slide 3 still active, on the Insert tab, in the Images group, select Online Pictures. In the Insert Pictures dialog box, under the Bing Image Search, type College and then press Enter. Choose any image you like that represents peer leadership at a college. Insert the image of your choice under the last bullet on Slide 3. If necessary, resize the picture so that it fits on the slide without overlapping with the text. Select the image you just added. On the Animations tab, in the Animation group, select the Fade Entrance effect. Once the animation is applied, notice the number 1 appears next to the image to indicate this is the first animation that will play. On the Animations tab, in the Advanced Animation group, turn on the Animation pane by clicking it one time. The Animation pane will open to the right of the screen. Click the down arrow next to the first animation, Picture 1, and select Effect Options. In the Fade dialog box, select the Effect tab, and under Sounds, choose Applause. Click the speaker icon to hear the applause and ensure your volume is turned up, but not too loud. Select OK to hear the applause sound you just applied. Close the animation pane. Select Slide 5, Fields of Interest. Select the text box with the bulleted list and change the font size of the text to 24. Move the text box up slightly if necessary. On the Insert tab, Images group, select Pictures. Browse to where your data files are stored and locate the image PowerPoint Practice 2, Step 20, and insert the image. Move the image so that it is in the white space to the right of Education, STEM, and Visual and Performing Arts. With the image on Slide 5 still selected, on the Picture Tools Format tab in the Size group, select the arrow under Crop, select Crop to Shape, and then select the oval shape under Basic Shapes. Notice how the shape crops to an oval. With the shape still selected, ensure the height is about 1.8 inches and the width is about 2.6 inches. If necessary, adjust the size and location of the image so that it is not overlapping any of the text and fits in the white space to the right of the text. Compare your slide to the example. Save your presentation and take note of where it is located. There should be a total of 6 slides in your slide deck. Compare your presentation to the example and make any modifications if needed. Close out of PowerPoint and submit your entire presentation per your instructor's instructions. I hope this video has helped you to complete this project. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to your instructor. They're here to help.